How is Hinduism transmitted from one generation to another generation for over thousands of years? We said there are certain people who got certain titles, and the titles that we hear are the word guru. Guru is derived from Sanskrit root, which means one who destroys ignorance. So it's a very generic title. So guru doesn't mean necessarily a spiritual teacher. It may be a computer guru or an economics guru. So guru is a title saying somebody who removes ignorance. The second term we use, very important, is Swami. Swami means an individual who has mastered himself. Again, these are very interesting individuals. And how do they impart their knowledge? And how, what is the process for imparting knowledge? It's very important for you to understand. And this, what the ancient Hindus taught, is very relevant for the world that we live in. They say, in order for knowledge to pass from the teacher to the student, there's a particular methodology you should adopt. And you may think it's outdated and it's old-fashioned, but it's still very relevant. It says, these are the three Sanskrit terms, pranam, prashna, seva. So what's that? Pranam means basically show respect. Respect not necessarily to the individual, but the knowledge he carries. And this is the secret I'm telling you. If you show respect to the subject you are studying, your teacher will soon find out that you are genuine, and he'll open his heart and give you all the information. So this idea of respect is not saying, dive at his feet and touch his feet. He simply says, show respect to the subject that he understands, because then you'll acquire that knowledge. Then the doorway of communication will open up. So pranam, second part, prashna, ask. Sometimes people feel shy or say, I look stupid if I ask a question. So they don't ask. Say, ask. If somebody knows something more than you do, if you don't ask him, he will not know what you are looking, what you are lacking. Ask. The third word which they use, which may sound again very old-fashioned, is always show not only respect to the subject, but to the carrier of that knowledge. Seva simply means making sure that the teacher is made very aware that you respect what he stands for. These are the three terms. You see how relevant they are in a modern world? Modern education system is struggling in the United Kingdom. You go through most of the schools, I'm telling you, some of them are a real nightmare. The teachers get beaten up. So this idea of pranam, prashna, seva is not a minor thing. Unless you have discipline, first thing is discipline, and you show respect to the subject, your subject carrier, then there are chances that you will learn. You'll open up the doorways of communication. So pranam, prashna, seva are not ancient ideas. Discipline and respect are still very crucial for the modern education system. Let me tell you how. You see, you'll find a lot of youngsters in the Far East, say Singapore, China, Malaysia, Korea, etc., are doing extremely well. They are very focused individuals in the studies. And one reason is this. They are disciplined individuals. They spend perhaps 10 hours extra studying every day. Literally, they work from morning till night. And the second most important, they show respect. So if a teacher, poor teacher from this country, goes to some of the Far East countries to try to teach, he'll be surprised at the amount of respect he receives. But the same teacher coming from China or here, he tried to teach here, will be frightened off by the children because they'll try and beat him up. They're forget about respect. So you see, these are very ancient words, but they're very crucial if you want to acquire knowledge of any kind, including knowledge of religion.